you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, God. We want to release any and everything right now. We want to give God any and everything that's on our minds and even inside of our hearts that's preventing us from coming into His presence. We don't want to be distracted by stuff, by people, by situations, by circumstances, by things that we think, believe, or even feel within our hearts. We do not want to allow ourselves to get into that place of being broken or even being dismangled. We want ourselves to be empty on today. We get so wrapped up with the cares of this world and this life and what we think others are thinking, what we think other people are saying, as well as what we are thinking about other people. So we want to just release all these things right now. Oh God, we're coming to you right now, Lord, in the name of Jesus. And we're going to empty ourselves out. We're going to empty out that situation, that concern, that worry, and even that problem. We're going to empty out all the cares of this world and this life right now. We're not going to worry about what's going on in our jobs and our homes and our marriages or even in our circumstances, because we're going to trust you with it right now, God. We're writing down all these things, Lord. We're throwing all these things at your feet, God. If there's a strain on our brain, God, we're even emptying that thing, God, unto you. Lord, we're not going to allow these things to consume us on today, God. We have asked you for some things and you have blessed us, God. And in the midst of you blessing us, God, we'd be more worried about the blessing, God, instead of the blesser. So we're going to empty that out at your feet right now, God. We're going to open up our hearts and our minds right now, Lord, in the name of Jesus, and we're going to be empty. Yeah, I just keep hearing empty it, empty it, empty it. Lord, we just want you today. We just want you right now, Father God, in the name of Jesus. We're not going to be so consumed, God. We're not going to be messed up, God. We're not going to be stuck, Lord. Oh, Lord, we're not going to allow ourselves to be hindered, delayed, Father God, and even deny anything that you have for us, God. Nothing, Father God, will we exalt higher than you. Nothing shall we put higher than you, God. We're going to empty these things out on today, Lord, in the name of Jesus, that we may get into a place of praise. We may get into a place of worship. Because you said, Lord, in the name of Jesus, that we ought to enter your gates with thanksgiving and enter your courts with praise. So we're going to do it right now, God. We're going to open up our mouths on today, Father God, in the name of my knee. Oh God, and we're gonna bless you. We're gonna bless you right now, God. We're gonna bless you right now, God, because you are worthy. We're gonna bless you right now, Father God, in the name of Jesus, because we know, God, that you are the only one, God. You are the reason for it all, God. We know you are the only one that can make it. Oh God, so we're gonna open up ourselves right now, God, and we're gonna welcome you into our hearts. We're gonna welcome you into our minds. We're going to welcome you into our situations. We're going to welcome you into the sanctuary. We're going to welcome you into our finances. We're going to welcome you into our health. We're going to welcome you right now, Father God, in the name of Jesus. We're going to open up the door right now, Father God. We're not going to slam it in your face. So therefore, we're not going to disregard what you're saying. We're going to open up the door right now, God. We're not going to hold it shut. We're going to willingly open it, God. And we're going to give you an invitation to come in. We're going to give you an invitation to rest, to rule and abide inside of our hearts on today. Uncork our ears, God. Remove the scales of our eyes that we may be able to clearly hear and see what the Spirit is saying to the church. Give us a heart of acceptance on today, God. That we may be able to accept your freedom. Help us on today, God. He cutting it up on sea to walk upright, to walk holy. Help us to eat the whole roll. Help us on today, Lord, in the name of Jesus. He cutting it up on sea and sever any and everything out of our hearts and our minds that's not like you. Remove any jealousy, enviousness, backbite, chillberry, covetousness, lavishness, maliciousness. Remove any debate or hate. Remove any pride on today. Remove any. Oh God, remove that. judgmental spirit and that opinionistic spirit. We're moving on today, Father God, because these seeds have a tendency of holding us bound. These seeds have a tendency of keeping us in a place of captivity. So we're asking you to help us. We're asking you to help us on today, God, that when we be me, I got shot in the like I see, I get a local shot in the eye. Oh God, that your will be done. That your will be done. That your will be done, God. Oh God, breathe on us today, God. And kept your angels in here, east, west, north, and south, from the roof to the very foundation around the entire perimeter. Oh God, let your spirit dwell in here, God. Swoon us and endow us on today with your presence. And help us, Father God. Help us on today to understand, God. Help us to have a heart to understand, God. Break up the fallow ground. Remove any and everything out of our hearts that's not like you on today, God. That your will be done in our hearts. Therefore, we will live our lives according to your purpose, which is holy, God. I'm asking you to do it on today, God, in the name of Jesus, because you said in your word that you have no delight that any of your people should perish, not even the very wicked. So help us on today, God. Help us right now, Father God, in the name of Jesus, that we will that we will not fall into that place of condemnation, but only conviction. Help us even now, God. In your son Jesus' name. Amen, amen, and amen. I hope y'all writing down all this stuff that you got all on your mind and all on your heart. I hope that you are releasing all these sins that have caused you to get into that place of condemnation. Please write down all this stuff. See, Jesus came down to the earth that we may be able to have life and have it in an abundance. That we may be able to recognize some things in our lives that is causing us to live a life that is not pleasing in his sight. So I'm not going to tarry this morning. I'm going to give y'all exactly what the Lord has given to me. And I want to explain some things to us on today that we may be able to understand. We're going to start in the book of John on this morning. I love you guys so much. And I pray to God that these things that he had me to say on today give us an understanding and a clear view of what we do each and every day, whether it's to others or even whether it is to our own selves. Whether it's to others or even to our own selves. Because we have a tendency of doing it knowingly as well as unknowingly. And we need to understand the difference of certain things. Because there's a lot of times that we hear a word or we believe what a word means. And then we only limit that word in one area where it applies in different areas as well as different perspectives. But because we are limiting certain things that we hear, that we see, or in our understanding, until we have not come into the place of understanding really what it is, because we do it to ourselves as well as we do it to others. I'm telling you what the Lord told me. The name of the sermon today is Judging the Judgeless. And then there's a colon. And there's two words after that that says those accusations. Judging the judgeless. And then there's a colon. And then it says those accusations. Now, we may think and believe that judging is only with pointing of the finger and wagging of the head. But please understand that you can judge your own self. You judge your own self simply by an opinion. And this is why I tell all of us, keep your opinions to yourself. Especially when it's concerning other people. We can judge people and it ain't even got to be in a bad way. Come on, y'all. See, we think judging is always pointing out a finger and wagging out a head when it's not. We think judging is when we are looking at somebody else's sin and comparing it with our sin. When I have told y'all constantly over and over that sin is simply sin. There's no big sin and there's no little sin. All unrighteousness is sin in the sight of God. Judging the judgeless. those accusations. We accuse our own selves of stuff. It could be good stuff, or it could even be bad stuff. It does not matter which way, how way, or what way you want to look at it or even think about it. Judging the judges. It's so many times that we go into this place, and in the midst of judging not just others, but judging ourselves, it'll take us to a place of condemnation. It'll take us to a place of regret. It'll take us to a place of, oh, I shouldn't have said that. Or I shouldn't have did that. Or you know what? I don't even know what I was thinking. Judging. Because this is what we do. And we do it oh so often. And we act like it's a privileged thing to do. We act like it's a privileged thing. That it's a lot of times that we get to judge it because of the experience that we done went through. And we have a tendency of accusing this person of this and accusing that person of that. But the Lord had me to open up something to us on this week when we was on the prayer line. He had me to open up, what did you say? What did you do? How did you act to make other people react to what you said or what you did that made them start saying some things or acting a certain type of way or giving their opinion, which is simply judging? That's what he said. Judging the judgeless. What is judging? To form an opinion about through careful weighing of evidence and testing of premises. How many times we done did that? How many times you done looked at a situation or perceived the situation and you start judging it? Oh, what you mean? I ain't judge nobody. No, but you gave your opinion. It just said an opinion is a judgment. And opinion, that's why I say them opinions don't even matter. Our thoughts don't even matter. Why? Because our thoughts will make us lean to our own understanding, which is what? An opinion. Because if you understand something a certain type of way, you got an opinion about it. I'm gonna prove it. What is judging? To form an estimate or an evaluation of. And didn't I just say that? To determine or pronounce after inquiry and deliberation. To form an opinion or reach a conclusion through reasoning and information or experiences. A person who impartially decides or resolves a dispute or controversy. That's judging. We done already came to a dog. You could be in a doggone conversation with somebody. And in the midst of your conversation, because of what they heard or what they perceived in the beginning, not listening to the conclusion, they done already start judging. Okay. Getting their opinion. That got to their own conclusion when they ain't even heard the entire matter. Is that not judging? Is that, and in their mind, what they start doing? Say accusing. Ooh, baby, those accusations. What you said, and you did, and you. The only reason why I was acting like that because of you. So you judging the whole situation or the conversation or the incident that both of us was involved in, and because of your judgment, which was all the evidence that you accumulated by your perception, has caused you to accuse and not evaluate you. Judging the judgeless. Come on now. Those accusations, those things that put us in a sense or in a place of, no, I know what you said. Yeah, you know part of what I said. Because your perception of what you heard and the reasoning that you came about because of your opinion only by the partiality, I just read it, has caused you to judge when you ain't even heard everything yet. You have not even allowed yourself to hear it because you still stuck on the first part, not paying attention to the middle and the end. And then when it's brought up again, you say, oh, well, I hear that part. Yeah, because you wouldn't be quiet. Or you weren't trying to hear it. Or you didn't want to accept it. Or you judged the matter by a word. And then you accused the other of what they said, which was a word, when you didn't hear the other say words because of your judgment of the conversation or what you saw or what you heard. Because sometimes you could walk up on a conversation like I did the other day when we was in here. Remember? We was in here and I walked up on there and I started saying something and then somebody said, that ain't what I say. You know what? Forgive me. Because I walked in on the end part and I just start assuming that I made an accusation that was not true. I did that when we was in here, didn't I? How many times you done walked up on something and only heard partiality of the conversation, but you assume, like on the prayer line the other morning, what's the name? One of the young ladies that was on there, she said, I knew that they were talking about me. Because they wanted me to hear, but you didn't know the whole thing. So you start accusing them. They may have been talking about you, but why? What did you do or what did you say to cause them to talk about you? What experience happened that caused the conversation to take place? It could have been anything. It could have just simply been, listen to this, their opinion. And their opinion caused you, because of what you heard them say about you, their opinion caused you to start judging them just as they judged you. We all do it. We all do it. So while they judging me, I'm judging them too. Because I'm acting like this because they acting like that. Is that not judging? I'm saying this because they saying that. They talking about me to them, so I'm going to go over here and talk about them to her. Or to the... Hey, come on. It's just the truth. Judging. The judgeless. Those accusations. They cause us to get into a place in our mind where we are in a cage. I told y'all he showed me that lion running around in that cage. We get mad and angry, especially when we trying to get our point across. Or we trying to get somebody to understand what we say. Anybody who talking to me, y'all gonna get mad at me a whole lot because I only understand what God say. Because he could the only one that can give me, you, him, earth, that we, all of us, the right understanding. Because we always what? Lean to our own understanding. That's why he's saying all you're getting, get an understanding. And then he goes on to say, don't lean to your own understanding. But we can't help it. Why? Because of our own opinions. And opinions is what? Judgments. I ain't making this stuff up, y'all. I'm finna prove it to y'all. I promise I'm going to the scripture. Judging the judgeless. Those accusations. Accusations. A charge of wrongdoing. A claim that someone has done something wrong or illegal. A charge that someone has committed a fault or a crime. How many times you done accused somebody of something? Now listen to this. This finna blow y'all. Now you done seen with your own eyes and you know that joker cheating on you. It ain't nothing that they can tell you. It ain't nothing that they can convince you because you seen it with your own eyes. So they can't even lie and say that's my cousin. They can't even, you know without a shadow of a doubt. So in the midst of you knowing, you start judging and giving your opinion. Now when you approach them, they start judging and giving their opinion. How can they give an opinion when they caught? How can you say anything and you're a liar? And the truth, evidence is right there, but you want to give your opinion and you want to try to accuse me of seeing the wrong thing and blatantly lie. But, so who judging who, y'all? Ain't y'all judging each other? Ain't y'all accusing one another? He accusing you of saying not, and you accusing him of no. I know what I saw. So it goes both ways. Whether you're wrong or whether you're right, you still making an accusation, which is an opinion, which is what? Judging. Which is judging. I'm going to prove it. Let's go to the book of John, y'all. Let's go to the book of John. I'm going to prove the truth. Chapter 8. John chapter 8. John chapter 8. And we're going to start from the top. Jesus went unto the Mount of Olives, and early in the morning he came again into the temple, and all the people came unto him, and he sat down and taught them. And the scribes and the Pharisees brought unto him a woman taken in adultery. And when they had set her in the midst, they say unto him, Master, this woman was taken in adultery in the very act. In other words, I saw her with my own eyes. She cannot lie and she cannot say anything because we all saw her. So we bring her to you. Now Moses in the law commanded us that such should be stoned. But what sayest thou? And this they said, tempting him. What is tempting? To entice, to do wrong by promise of pleasure or gain. To induce, to do something. To lead away from a usual or proper course by offering some pleasure or advantage. To take a chance on. So, you know how they've been judging Jesus all this time. They done gave their opinions. They done whispered. Done went and talked behind his back. They done try to recruit people to believe what they believed concerning him. They done tried to say he was a false prophet, a devil worshiper, and that he was even the devil himself. They done said, oh man, so they're coming to test them. How many times people done came and tried to test you? Somebody done said to me several times in my past and even currently in this life, they done said to me, well, I done made the statement, I hear what you're thinking. And what am I thinking then? What? Trying to tempt me. They trying to mock God. Because what they don't understand is when a statement is made by God, I know what you're thinking. They think about the thoughts. God goes a little deeper than your thoughts because he know our thoughts will cause us to be doomed. He knows that. That's why he say be transformed. So he ain't talking about what you think you understand. Or what you think you think. What you think you think. He's such a comedian. And the scribes and the Pharisees brought unto him a woman taken in adultery. And when they had set her in the midst, they said unto him, Master, this woman was taken in adultery in the very act. Now Moses in the law commanded us that such should be stoned. But what sayest thou? In other words, they trying to tempt him. Listen to me. They trying to tempt him with the word of God. It has been people that has came to me and say, well, the Bible says this. And you are saying that. Well, what understanding you got? Because you lean into your own understanding. Because the understanding of the scripture, the Bible declares that he shall not be mocked. His word is true. So you take that and you done perverted it to apply it to your accusation, your foolishness. Listen to this. This they said tempting him that they might have to accuse him. What? I just told y'all what accuse is, right? They wanted to accuse him. But Jesus stooped down and with his finger wrote on the ground as though he heard them not. So in other words, he ignored that mess. You coming to somebody and they done already told you or said something to you about the Lord, and then you say, well this or well that. So you trying to tempt God. You trying to tempt what the Lord is saying. You trying to, he go, just like him, I'm going to ignore you. I'm going to ignore you because I'm scared for you. I'm scared for you. Listen to this. So when they had continued asking him, he lifted up himself and said unto them, he that is without sin among you, let him first cast a stone at her. And again he stooped down and wrote on the ground. And they which heard it, being convicted by their own conscience. See, I'm finna get to the good part. Went out one by one, beginning at the eldest, even unto the last. And Jesus was left alone and a woman standing in the midst. When Jesus had lifted up himself and saw none but the woman, he said unto her, woman, where are those thine accusers? Have no man condemned thee? What is condemned? Condemned is to declare to be reprehensible, wrong, or evil, usually after weighing evidence and without reservation. To adjudge unfit for use or consumption. How many times you have judged somebody by the evidence that you have already received? How many times you thought somebody was wrong to you and you went to the Lord and you start praying and start accusing them of doing something or acting some type of way and you didn't hear nothing from God? You didn't hear anything from God, but you going to tell on somebody. How many times have you went and confided in somebody and you telling or expressing or then or doing whatever you think that you thought that you can do, that you are accusing that person or judging, and you say and you believe that you were not talking about them or accusing them of something when you were simply just venting? That's a lie. You was judging and you was accusing that person of something. Why? Because you mad. Of things ain't going your way. How many times did you done call somebody or even sat down and talk to somebody over dinner or over breakfast, and they start talking about another person, and you sitting there like, oh Jesus, because they're judging about something that they experienced or not experienced, or something didn't go their way. And so they want to give their opinion about the matter. And their opinion, it causes you to... So then you start judging them. Then you start judging them because of what they said. I can't believe they saying this. I don't even understand why they saying this, because I don't... It's both ways. They wrong and you wrong and I'm wrong and he wrong and they, everybody wrong, because we judging one another. Even if you catch somebody in the very act. How many times you done seen your child or your grandchildren or somebody, your husband, your, they do, you be like, no, well, why you do that? What make you do that? I saw you did it. This what they do. This the... Or either they'll start trying to give an explanation as to their actions. And in the midst of them giving that explanation, what you start doing? Judging in your mind. Now, I don't even know why they... What? We do. That's what we do. I'm just talking about me. Us, all of us have did that. Say we still do it. And still do it. We still do it. Let somebody use your car. And you know where your gas tank was. And then when they bring it back, it, well, they ain't even put no gas in there. What the world? Is that judging? It's judging because why they ain't put no gas? So now you mad because you judging and you venting and you talking and you doing. So you, how you know they ain't have no money? Are they, but you instead of going to them, you venting to somebody else. Or even not, you ain't even got to say nothing to nobody. How about you judge and make accusations to yourself? Yo, I'm talking about me. I'd be like, you know what, Lord, I can't keep doing this. What am I doing? I'm judging. And the Lord been dealing with me about us, me, you, him, her, that we, all of us in that place of judging one another, giving our opinions, which is what? An accusation. We so quick to point the finger at somebody else. Well, you said, or no, you did, and I saw you, and you didn't do, and you, what the world is we doing? What are we doing? When we get to that place of accusing one another, it puts that person in a place of being shameful, embarrassed, because they feel guilty or they don't want to be found out, and then they don't want to confess. So now they in bondage because they ain't doing what the Lord say, because don't nobody want to take accountability for nothing. Don't nobody want to say, "Whoa, I did that." I did that because you blaming me for your own actions. I tried to do that before. I walked here in the sanctuary and there was something being done and a certain action was being performed against me. And so I said, you know what, I'm sick and tired of it. I'm going to act the same way. And then when I start acting the same way, the Lord said, what is you doing? I said, well, I'm doing it because she did. He said, let me tell you something, Pastor. He said, you cannot accuse nobody else for your actions that you chose. You ain't have to act like that because somebody else acting like that. You ain't got to think like that because you feel. Don't mess around and have discernment. Whew. You know what they thinking, what they acting, and how you know if they thinking, if they really. And so now, your opinion in your mind, you never got to say nothing. It goes into a place of judging. Help us, Lord. Say it again, God. Help us, Lord. Because we all judgmental. Am I just talking about event? I'm just talking about event. I'm just talking about me because it had to come to me first. We are judgmental. For what? When we start judging, it takes us to a place of condemning somebody else. The Bible says we're supposed to do that. Why we're supposed to do that? Well, let's find out why. Let's go to the book of Matthews. Let's find out why we're supposed to be judging one another. Let's go to the book of Matthews. Because we walking around here on our high horse. Ain't nobody holier than thou. Ain't nobody got it together. Neither have nobody obtained. He said that in our daily devotional when we was on the prayer line. It's not as if I have obtained. No, ain't nobody obtained. Jack Dilly or Squad, because if you did, you would still be walking around here. I ain't going to say breathing. Say judging. Give me your opinion. Matthews chapter 7. Judge not that ye be not judged. For with what judgment ye judge, ye shall be judged. And shall be... I'm going to start over because I got excited. I got excited. Because this was good to me this morning. I don't know about nobody else. If it hurt, just say ouch and digest it. Because baby, let me tell you, it's tight, but it's right, and it'll help us. Matthew chapter 7. Judge not that ye be not judged. So stop sitting there thinking of what that. Can I tell y'all something that y'all may not know or understand? Y'all know how we be sitting down and we get to thinking and then we say, I don't want people to be looking at me funny. I don't want people to look at me different. So why are they looking at me? Why are you judging yourself? And you judging others. All wrapped up in one. How? Because you judge. What you say?
Accusing them of judging you.
And you judging your own self. As well as you judging them. Those accusations. We do it to our own selves. We be so worried about what other people think about us until we judging ourselves. And well, they think that I'm not. How you know that's what they think? They, how about they ain't thinking about you? And then is that not captivity in our mind? I don't want them to think this. I don't want them to. So I'm going to do this. How about judging leads us? When we judge ourselves, it leads us to want to have to prove ourselves. We got to prove ourselves. I'm going to show them. You judging your own self and working your own self for nothing. Because guess who don't give a rat's tail? Yo. Seriously. We judge. We got to get to a place where we ain't worrying about what nobody else saying, what they thinking, how they feeling, what, because it causes us to judge ourselves as well as judging. Oh, they going to judge. I gave that testimony or I confessed that. Now you worrying about what people think. Drop the mic on that. Why are you worried about you? You still ain't free. You confess, but you ain't free, because in the midst of your confession, you worrying about what other people's opinions is. You ain't free. The purpose of the confession is not to worry about what nobody else say. That's why you got enough courage to confess. Because if you don't confess, you really going to be worried about what they saying. Or what their opinion is. Oh, wait a minute. Of those accusations. And that's just real talk. Matthew 7. Judge not that ye be not judged. For with what judgment ye judge, ye shall be judged. And with what measure ye meet, it shall be measured to you again. So just as much as you judge other folk, you are going to be judged the same amount. God shall not be mocked, but you sow that shall you reap. And why beholdest thou the mote that is in thy brother's eye? What is a mote? The Webster says it's a small particle. So you talking about that little sin. Listen to this one. It's got good to me. For what judgment ye judge, ye shall be judged. And with what measure ye meet, it shall be measured to you again. And why beholdest thou the mote that is in thy brother's eye, but considerest not the beam that is in thy own eye? What is a beam? A spotlight, baby. Your sin is pow, but you worrying about my little sin. You worrying about that you thinking or your opinion or your viewpoint has caused you to accuse me about a small matter when you got a big matter exposed. Please be quiet and let's confess to one another. Please don't think like that, because you're going to start judging yourself. And then don't you know when you start judging yourself, it falls into a place of condemnation. What did Jesus say to you? He said, well, where's all the people that accused you of something? That's why when people get to accusing me of stuff, I be, hey, that, you better stop accusing me. Because why you accusing me? You better look at what you doing You better look at what God is trying to show you about you. It's this individual that I know. Every time the Lord have me to tell that man something, he'll try to say, well, you such and such and such. And then and so the last time the Lord say, tell him I ain't dealing with you. I'm dealing with him right now. I said, the Lord told me to tell you, prophet, that he's not dealing with me right now. He's dealing with you. Girl, you can hear a pin drop. You can hear a pin drop. Because let me tell you something about God. When he come to you and he start dealing with you about something and you don't want to accept it or you keep disregarding it, baby, he gonna send somebody else to expose that being. That's that being, baby. That's that being. Why you looking at, because so many people, you supposed to be a pastor, you supposed to be a prophet, you supposed to be a woman of God. I say, I sure do. So is you judging me or is you accusing me? You accusing me of being a pastor, prophet, or even a woman of God. Is that a true accusation or is it a lie? Well, you supposed to be, I guess it's true. I say, well then baby, don't accuse me of it. Say you are a pastor. You are a prophet. Don't come to me with your judgmental accusations of something that you think and not what you know. You gotta have a surety of that thing supposed to be. That be blowing me. Cause I know who I am. Do you know who you is? I know who God says I am. And I walk in assurance, not pride. And that's for sure. So why beholdest thou the mote that is in thy brother's eye, but considerest not the beam that is in thine own eye? And that's why he had me to say on the prayer line, wait a minute, hold it. Why you accusing and why you venting and why you saying this and why you judging this and judging that? Did you consider why they said this or said that or acted that way? You mad at the person that you're venting to? You mad at the person that you talk to? Well, you the one that started it off with your accusations, with your venting. And what is venting? Opinions. It's your perspective. It's how you feel. It's how, this is why I always tell people, God loves to talk. Go to him and talk. Because a person could take one word, one statement, and run wild with it and make the situation or the conversation worse than what it really is. They will make it worse than what you said it was. They will make you, they'll throw you under the bus. And you only was saying a matter of an opinion of yourself, which was judging, not understanding that you were doing it. See, these are the things that we do unknowing. This is why I pray, Lord, help us even in our unknowing. So now that you know and understand, because he got me preaching to you, don't do it no more. It don't matter what you did before or what the incident was. Don't put yourself in that place of condemnation. Let me prove it to you. Or how would thou say to thy brother, let me pull out the mote of thine own eye, and behold, a beam is in thine own eye. Thou hypocrite. What is a hypocrite? A person who professes to be one thing or act one way and then they not. It's a secret thing. First cast out the beam out of thy own eye, and then thou shalt see clearly to cast out the mote out of thy brother's eye. That's why I don't mind confessing my mess. Because if I confess my mess and talk about me, then I may be able to clearly see to help you. Let me say that again. If I'm not ashamed, embarrassed, or guilty, or condemning my own self, and can openly show that being about my own mess, then I could come and pluck out that, take that piece of lint off you. That's why I don't mind telling my business. Oh my, because if I can get past that shame, embarrassment, and that guilt, then I'll be able to help you to get past it. And that would be able to help you to confess. In your confession, it will not be judging, and you will not give that opinion, and therefore there will not be no accusations. Because when we go to that place, let me tell y'all what happens next. This is what happens next. Thou hypocrite, first cast out the beam out of thy own eye, and then shall thou see clearly to cast out the mote of thy brother's eye. Give not that which is holy unto the dogs, neither cast ye your pearls before swine, lest they trample them under their feet and turn again and rend you. How many times you done went to somebody and tried to help somebody, baby, and they done tried to bite you? Now, you've given them holy things. You've given them things that can help you. But because they don't have a heart of acceptance, they will try to read scripture or quote a scripture to you and try to make it apply to justify for their accusations, their foolishness, their judgments. And you steady saying, wait a minute, baby, you can't even hardly get a word out. Let's go to the book of Galatians. Let me prove to you that we need to be more concerned for one another. Galatians chapter 6. Brethren, if a man be overtaken in a fault, what is overtaken? To come upon you suddenly. What is a fault? A responsibility for wrongdoing or failure. To express one's unfavorable opinion of the worth or quality of. A defect in our character. Listen. The Bible says, brother, if a man be overtaken in a fault, ye which are spiritual, restore such a one in the spirit of meekness, considering thyself, lest thou also be tempted. So in other words, I'm not going to come to you and act like I got it all together. I'm not. If I see that thing is overtaking you, I'm going to let you know. Because I'm spiritual and I'm not thinking carnal. Now let me tell you something. Everybody that is spiritual, please understand, they think carnal too. For the Bible declares first natural, then that which is spiritual. But if we are looking at one another without judging, without accusing, and without our opinions, and we're not leaning to our own understanding, we are allowing the spirit man to be activated in our thoughts, to be activated that we could see God's viewpoint, to be activated that we may be able to hear what the spirit is saying to the church. And so we're going to go to them, and not in pride, not Bible whooping them, not make. And letting them know. For the Bible declares that when we do it, we're supposed to do it in meekness. That they may be restored. To restore is make anew and afresh. To give them more vigor. To give them more enthusiasm. But who wants to be found out? We don't want to be found out, and we don't want to accept nothing. We don't want to hear nothing, and lo and behold, we sure ain't finna confess it. So when I see you overtaking anything, I'm going to come to you and I'm going to tell you. Now the Bible says such, 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 such. Now the Lord told me to come to you and tell you such, 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 such. And you, baby, don't get mad and don't get angry, because when we are coming to one another, we are coming to one another. Because what? I love you. So I'm not going to come to you and say, you know what, you need to stop doing such and such and such and such. That's not meekness at all. The Lord told me to tell you such and such and such and such and such. And you need to try to such and such and such and such and such. Or try it a little harder. Because sometimes we be tempted. Or provoked. Or it's a struggle. So just try to press a little bit harder. Just try to do a little bit more. Or just not. It does not mean I'm judging you. So when I come to you and I tell you these things, it make you embarrassed. It make you shame. It make you feel some type of way. And in the midst of you feeling that type of way, then what happens, y'all? We get an attitude. Or we get quiet. Or we put our chin in our neck. Or we shut down or we turn away or we separate ourselves. So that ain't what that's for, because that's still captivity. And you are judging yourself, condemning yourself, thinking these things because you believe everybody else is doing it to you or towards you. This is what we do. He's talking about judging the judgeless on today. Those accusations that we even give our own selves. We don't want to fall into that place of condemnation within our own selves, because God is not a God of condemnation, but he is a God of conviction. And if he convicts you in your conscience, then you have to make the choice to get it together within yourself. Then you ain't got to worry about nobody coming and telling you, because God done already done told you. And if you taking heed and you trying to change, then you ain't got to. And I just sat up here and told y'all that if he come to you and he telling you something and you being stiff necked, hard hearted, and don't want to hear, he gonna send somebody to you. He's not gonna always come to you, baby. Don't it? Because of your stiff neck and because of your hard heart, he's gonna come to you rough. He said, do I have to pull out my iron rod? Is it a pull? God is a God of correction. He have no delight that any of us should perish. So I want y'all to understand today what judging the judgeless is. Those accusations is not just you judging others, but you judging yourself and putting yourself in a place of judging others with those opinions, with those accusations, and with those feelings, or what you think or believe that other people are saying, or what you think or believe other people are doing. Judging the judgeless. Those accusations. So please write down this stuff. Write down those things that you think and believe that has caused you to judge others, when in actuality that you are judging your own self as well as others. You are condemning your own self as well as you condemn others. We don't want to fall into a place of condemnation. How many times you done went and vented? How many times you done went and said this and said that? How many times all these things has happened to you when you thought and believed that you was there, when in actuality you was judging others as you judge yourself? Or how about judging others and don't judge yourself? Remember what I just read. Everything that you do and judge towards other people, the same thing is going to come upon you. Judge not that ye be not judged. And I gave y'all the scripture in John concerning them. Everybody could. Well, let me go. It's proven that we want to recruit people to help us judge other people, because that's what they did with the adulterous woman. They recruited people. They recruited other folk. And they all went running to Jesus. Jesus looked at them and said, I'm so sick and tired of these foolish things. The Bible says he bent down and ignored them as if they wasn't saying nothing. And then they kept saying it, kept saying it. How many times somebody keep gnawing and saying certain other things unto you that make you think unbelieve or even act a certain type of way in the midst of the judging? So our opinions and our thoughts are judgmental. Be careful. Confess. You can always go to God and talk to God about stuff, because he is an audible God and he want to hear. He wants you to come. He said, acknowledge me in all your ways. So acknowledge him in your anger, baby. Acknowledge him when you sad, when you mad, when you think somebody did you wrong. Because in the midst of it, he's going to show you, while you telling him they're wrong, he's going to show you you're wrong. Accept it. Accept what the Lord is trying to show you, or what he's trying to tell you, or what even what he's trying to teach you. Because it gets hard and it becomes a struggle for us. It gets hard and it becomes a struggle for us because we are so adamant about our thoughts and our opinions, which are judging one another. We got to be careful with that. We have to. So please, write these things down. Yellow sheets of paper and red pens. We do not want to be judgmental. We do not want to get ourselves into that place. And remember what he just said. You can judge your own self. You judge your own self by condemning yourself. Don't condemn yourself. What I should have did, or what I shouldn't have did, or how I should have did it, or they did this and they did that. Judging or judgeless, those accusations. We don't want to get into that place anymore, y'all. If you think somebody did something wrong to you, or wrong towards you, or and you got an opinion about that, that is judging. If you think or know or feel, that is just, and it could be right or it could be wrong. Don't you know judging falls in either category? In either category. Let me tell y'all a conversation that I had with this representative. I had a meeting on a couple weeks ago, and she called me into her office. And in the midst of me going into her office, while I was sitting down talking to her, and we were, you know, talking about some things, I asked her a question, and in the midst of her asking her a question, let me tell you how God been dealing with me about this stuff, and he had me to preach it today. I asked her a question. I said, well, have you, you know, have anybody else, you know, said anything to you, or, you know, just being curious? And then she said, no. I said, well, shoot, they don't want it bad enough. Just like that. She said, you know what, Miss Yvette, I said the same thing. And then the Lord said, why y'all sitting up here judging? I say, you know what? I shut it right on down, baby. I shut it right on down. Look, and went to a whole nother conversation. I went to a whole nother conversation because even in our curiosity, because we give our own opinion, it's judging. When we really don't even know the circumstances of people, I say, well, they don't want it bad enough. It ain't that, maybe not. They do want it bad enough, but they just don't fit the criteria. Or they just can't make it. Or something happened and they couldn't make it. We don't know, but because of what we think or what we see, and because of our own thoughts and opinions, it fell into a place of what? Judging. And I accuse people I ain't even know of an act or an action when I don't even know what happened or what could have happened. Come on. You see how easy it is? It is so easy. How easy is it for you to accuse your own self? Let me give you an example. I don't know why he got me going over it again, but I got to. Let me give you an example. We, or something happened or something was done, and it was around other people. Now we sitting there messed up because we thinking that they thinking different or a certain type of way about us. Is we not judging our own selves in a negative way? When in actuality, how about in your confessions? You worrying about what people think or how they feel about you when you simply confess. And the Bible said confess that you may be free. You're not free because you confessing it, but yet you picking up something else because you worrying about what somebody else is saying. You what, girl? You dropped off shame and embarrassment, but you picked up. Girl, said
dropped off shame, embarrassment, and picked up opinions.
Yeah. And so we empty the side of the duffel bag and steady stuff the inside of it. No, we not finna keep judging like that. And that's judging ourselves, keeping our own self. Oh, look, we be so worried about what other people think about us, and so it causes us to try to prove ourselves or even show them something different from what we think, which is an opinion, they thinking. Is that not captivity? That's bondage. And it's judging you as well as judging them all at the same time. What are we doing, y'all? We've been praying for the last few weeks. Lord, teach me how to receive everybody. This part of the teaching. Helping us in an area where we are in captivity in our own thoughts. Stop worrying about what other people say. That's bondage. and is judging yourself as well as others, which take you to a place of condemnation. And God is not a God of condemnation, but of conviction. If he's convicting you within your spirit, that's in your conscience, then you're automatically going to choose to do right. If it is condemnation, then the enemy is tricking you to believe that you can't do right. And that's a lie. Because I know we can do right because of two things. The blood of Jesus on that cross, and he gave us a free will choice. Those two things right there can give us that get right spirit, that do right thing, that overturn it. So I want y'all to write these things down. Lord, help me not to be judgmental, not just to others, but to myself. Lord, teach me to keep my opinions to myself. And help me not to be opinionistic. Give me clarity in the things that I don't understand, that I won't put myself in a place of condemnation, shame, embarrassment, or fear. We fear to confess because we're so worried about what other people going to think until we stay in bondage, not in one area, but 10 other areas. That's what we do to our own selves. We think and believe that God is not a God that can help us, or that can change a thing, or that can move a thing. Or when we do something wrong, we be so worried about what other people say. God be done already forgave us. And then we, example, I can do something to you, and I know it was something bad. And so God starts convicting me, and I start feeling bad about doing it. So I come to you and I say that I'm sorry. Please forgive me for that. Then that's over with. But if the devil keep bringing it up to you and up to me, because I'm giving myself as an example, if the devil keep bringing it up to me, then he trying to condemn me and make me think or believe that you didn't forgive me, and neither did God, and neither can I do better. So I'm judging myself because I've been deceived by the devil. I have been deceived by the devil. Now, I done told you I was sorry. And every time it's thought about, or every time it's spoke about, or every time a conversation come up about, I get to feeling some type of way. Because it's been, then the devil is trying to condemn you and make you think and believe that that's still you. So, this song. Write down all this stuff. We already know. Listen to these words, y'all. I'm going to be writing down stuff too while y'all listening to the words. Because I'm not exempt. show me all my wrongs and wash me. Forgive me. Forgive me. And then save me from myself. Restore me. Talking about the Lord. Write down this stuff. Don't allow yourself to get into that place of condemnation when the Lord is trying to show you freedom. He is trying to get you to that place. He is a God of second, third, fourth, 100 chances. We don't want to allow ourselves to be in that place. Or even to stay in that place. So don't judge yourself. Don't worry about what other people are saying. Don't worry about what other people are doing. Don't put yourself in that place of condemnation. I did not say don't evaluate yourself, because you have a choice to do right or wrong. But don't allow you in your evaluation to judge and go into a place of condemnation. I just want y'all to understand that, because the Bible declares that we ought to evaluate ourselves. So please write these things down. Write your name on a sheet of paper. And the first word, I want you to write down judgmental and then opinions. Judgmental, opinions, and condemnation. The second page, write your name. And I want you to write down acceptance, honesty, and truth. He loves us like that. He'll keep giving us chance after chance. That don't mean that we gotta be substance abusers now, because he'll turn us over into a reprobate. On the third sheet of paper, write down purge, purification, and sanctification. I'm so glad. In spite of me, you forgive me. In spite of my wrongs, you love me, Lord. Time after time after time. Time after time after time. Your mercies.
Your mercy, Lord.
Every time. Stay right there with me. You are
the God of a second chance. I am
judging the judgeless. Those accusations. That was the name of our sermon on today. Life. We got right, y'all. And we got chance after chance after chance. We get weak, but we got. God knows that we fall, but he give us another chance. He knows we've done wrong. Don't let yourself go into a place of condemnation now. Please. Please. Because this time, we want to get it right. We want to get it right this time. We want to do it His way. If by chance you was not here to hear the sermon, you're going to have to go on the website and hear it. Because y'all know when He done, I'm done. Write those things down on the prayer line. You could come and join us on that. It's 5 o'clock every morning. We want to get it right. Write those things down, and when you get done, please bring them and put them on the altar. If y'all still need to know what was said, y'all gonna have to ask one another, because when He get to having me to tell y'all to write that stuff, I don't be remembering that thing. Now mind you, I done wrote mine down already.
No guilt or shame this time.
Write your name on a sheet of paper and write, "Help me, Lord." He said, "I already did that." Look, because it's hard. He said, "I already did that." That's all I'm saying. When we know to ask the Lord for some help, help me, Lord.
Because
we want to get it right this time. Make sure y'all keep Ricky and Shay in your prayers. They have traveled to Ohio. Because Shay's father passed away. So they're not here today. And Gloria got all the babies. 30 of them. She got 5. I always say 30. Yes. Anybody you don't see, please make sure you pray for them. Remember what the sermon was today. Judging the judgeless, those accusations. It's just going to help us. Help us to be able to be more mindful of our opinions and what we think, even in the inside, and we ain't even got to speak it. About our own selves as well as others. I love you guys so much. I hope it was something said on today that can help you to remember these things. After you get through writing them down, please bring them and put them on the altar and start praying for yourself. And then I'm going to pray with you. Help us, Lord. If you want to stand in the gap for somebody, please stand in the gap for somebody. Write down all them old hurts and all that stuff that has caused you to be in a tizzy fit.
So I'm telling anyone who listens, I'll testify about how good you were to me when so-called friends passed me by.
Thank you, Jesus.
Show somebody so
He give us so much mercy.
So
help us, Lord, to get it right this time. We may not be able to want to accept it, or we may not be able to understand it, God, but help us to get it right this time. Prepare us, Father God, in the name of Jesus, to accept your correction, God, and to understand what the Spirit is saying to the church. Give us a strength, God, to keep pressing. Give us the hope, God, to keep believing. Give us a stamina, God, to keep standing. Hi, get a local shut up. Hi, God. Hey, God. Hey, God. We don't want to be in captivity. We don't want to hold on to all this stuff, God, that causes us to judge ourselves, that causes us to judge one another, to have all these opinions, Lord, in the name of Jesus, that causes us to go into a place of accusations, Lord, or point a finger, wagging a head, Lord. So we want to release these things on today, God. We want you to sanctify us, God. We want you to purge us, God. We want you to purify us, Lord. We want you to move all these things on today, God, because we want to be free. We want to be free from any of see, even in our minds of what other people think, God. Even in the midst of us confessing. Even in the midst of our deal, go see. Help us, God. Help us, God. He got that in our shot. Not to hold on to these things, God. Causing our own selves to go into a place of condemnation. Oh, God. But give us your spirit of conviction that we may be able to make the right choice, God. And do the right thing. And think the right way. That we may be able to act the right way. Help us, God. Oh, God. God, we want to get it right. We don't want to fall victim. We want the Yoko Shana. We don't want to get back in that place, God. Because if you crack that sky, we want to be able to get caught up with you, God. We don't want hell to enlarge itself. That will make room for us. Oh, God. We want to get it right today, the Yoko Shana. Oh, God. He got me to look go see. We don't want to be falling in between and in between so today, Lord. Hey. Help us, God. To get it right this time. Help us on today, Lord. That you may be able to make us over. Make us over on today, God. That we will not judge. Make us one another and even our own selves. That we fall into a place of condemnation. Help us on today, God. Help us on today, God. Give us your peace. Give us your hope. Give us your direction. Give us new characteristics on today, God. And make us over. That we will not think the same. We will not act the same. We will not do the same. But we will do what you designed us to do. We will do it the right way, God. Open up our hearts and our minds on today, God. As we outpour these things. As we release these things. As we give you all these things. Because we don't want to keep them, God. We don't want to keep them, God, thinking that we're doing right. We don't want to have to worry about what other people are thinking. But we want to think like you, God. We want to be more like you, God. So help us on today, God. Make us over, Lord. Make us over, God. Make us over on today, God. Even as we stand in the gap for one another, God. Even as we release some things, Father God, that's hidden down in the inside of our hearts. Make us over, God. He come near the local, shun near the like I see. Give us that peace. Give us that hope. Give us that direction. Give us that clarity. We don't want to lean to our own understanding, God. Help us to understand you more. We don't want to lean to our own understanding, God. Give us your understanding. Help us on today, God. That we may be able to have some peace. Peace in our minds. Of what we think other people think. Oh yeah, give us that peace. Peace in our hearts. Of things that we have already done, God. Peace, God. And knowing that you have already forgiven us, Lord, that we may be able to forgive ourselves, God. Time after time, God. We have did things over and over again, God. We chose to do that wrong thing. But today, God, we're confessing and acknowledging, taking accountability for our actions, God. And we laying it down at your feet. Make us over, God, that we won't do it again. Let us consider. Let us regard these things, God. That your will be done within our lives, Lord. Help us on today, God. Help us now, God, as we empty these things out to you, God. All that old stuff, God. Help us, Lord. We just want to be right in your sight. We want you to look at us and say, good and well done, my faithful servant. Make us over, God. He can't let it look see. He can't let it look shut now. Let us not point the finger and wag the heads at one another. He can't let it look shut like I see. Oh, God, help us, God. Give us meek and lowly spirits on today, God, that we will not walk in that place of pride, Jesus. Help us, God. He come near the local shana, that we will not be haughty, God, when we try to help one another, Father God. And then you'll go see through your spiritual realm. Make us over, God. Sever that spirit of carnality on today, God. That we can help ourselves as we help others. Make us over, God. Make us over, God. Even now, God. In your son Jesus' name. Amen, amen, and amen. Just keep asking the Lord to make you over. All the stuff and all the things that we hold down in the inside. We Because we hold in so much. So many grudges and hostility. And because of what we think and believe a person said or done. Think about yourself, what you said or done and made them act that way. The conversations that you had. Lord, make us over, God. Make us over today, God. Make us over today, God, as we outpour these things unto you, Lord. We're not going to come to you on behalf of nobody else but ourselves on today. That you could cleanse us and wash us, God. And make us clean. Even now, God. Even now, God. Help us, Lord. We tell you that we love you, Lord. And we thank you in advance for considering our prayers. And we thank you in advance for listening to our petitions, Lord. We thank you in advance because we are in expectation for what you are about to do in our lives. And we tell you we love you, God. In your son Jesus' name, amen, amen, and amen. You may be seated if you want to. I thank God on today for his word, judging the judgeless, those accusations. I thank God for giving us that peace that we need, even in the midst of it all. I love you guys so, so very much. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. I hope I said something on today that will help you. That's why I be trying to tell the folk and the people to come early. You be to miss everything. I ain't putting you on front. I ain't doing that. I love you guys so, so very much. The name of the sermon today was Judging the Judgeless. Those accusations. So we got to make sure that we ain't judging one another. Amen, Lord. Help me not to judge the folk that's coming in. Thank you, Jesus. Because of our perception of things. And remember that we all are helpers one to another. And we all need Jesus. Make us over, Lord. We're going to get ready to get our tithes and our offering. Anybody need an envelope, please raise your hand. If you missed the sermon, if you missed the sermon on today, if you missed it, Aries, get the people the envelopes for me, baby, please. If you give them to her so she can give them to the people, please. If you missed the sermon, please go on our website or YouTube. The name of the sermon today is Judging the Judgeless, Those Accusations. It helped me. It helped me because we be so worried about what people think, what they said, and how they acted. And we always judging one another. So we got to stop the judging, y'all. Because we all here together, getting it together, together. It ain't no big sin or no little sin. All unrighteousness is sin in the sight of God. Please understand that. Please understand that. I love you guys to bits and pieces. And I thank God for you guys. Anybody that you don't see, please pray for them. I told you some people that is traveling. So they could not be here today. Thank you, Jesus. Some people came and gave me their tithes and they offered and listened. Because I told my grandchildren, they would text me, Grandma, you coming to pick us up for church today? Because we want to go to church and such, 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 such. So my daughter called me and she was like, your grandkids is waiting on you to text them and see, tell them they ain't come. I ain't coming today because I ain't coming straight home. And so I knew I wasn't coming straight home when I got out of church today. So I didn't go get my grandbabies. And my granddaughter came downstairs this morning and she said, Grandma, we wanted to go to church. I said, well, y'all going to church with your mama today. You, I said, well, I thank God my grandkids love to come to church. Because they sure be wanting to come, even though I be fussing at them. And I have my little stick out. Thank you, Jesus. I thank you guys. I thank you guys for considering what the Lord has said on today. I love the Lord so much, and He knows just what we need. And He have been dealing with us on the prayer line about the judging. And we think judging is always pointing the finger and wagging the head at other people, but we get to judging our own selves, putting our own selves in a place of condemnation. You know, our opinions. He said opinions is judging. So we just have to be careful, y'all. We got to be careful. Because we all here together, getting it together, together. Everybody messed up in some form or some fashion. Your sin, he had me read it. How can you get that mote out of your brother eye when you got a beam in your eye? That mote, it says, is a small particle. But a beam is something that's just, you know, so how can I help you when come on now. We just got to be careful about judging. Let's just not judge ourselves, put us in a place of condemnation, or judging nobody else. Stop giving your opinions all the time. Sometimes you just got to be quiet because you can't reason with a fool. Stop trying to reason with the fools because they not hearing nothing that you're saying. The Bible says, cast not your pearls before swine, because they would try to come back on you and rend you like a dog. Come on, y'all. Just be careful with that. And know that I love you. Let's hold them tithes and offering up in the air and give God back just what He gave unto us. I thank Him for His word on today, because He woke me up talking about that thing all week long.